Question arises, what is the similarity between a color-changing chameleon, a morpho butterfly, blue Lexus car that is way out of my league, this nice-looking berries, and this daredevil spider which gives me nightmare? So welcome all to the world of Photonic Crystal and Structural Color, second edition. So we'll be performing experiment at the end of the video. Advantages of structural color is that it is brighter, has higher resolution, it has the ability to change color if one changes surface structures, it can also withstand high temperature, sunlight, rainy season, in short all weather condition. In this paper they have produced colors with ultra thin nanostructure metal film. The metal here used is silver, which is only 30 nanometer thick. This is also called subtractive color filtering. This means light that cannot pass through the grating gets reflected. Hence, if the period between the structures or the grating is less, blue light passes but red gets reflected. Hence, we can see red color. The whole structure is made with FIB milling or focused ion beam milling, which we'll be discussing later in the video. Physics behind this color filtering is also called plasmonic subtractive color filter. Link of this paper is given in the description. Here you can see reflected color changes from yellow to red, purple to blue as grating period changes. This paper is an ideal example of biomimicking. Biomimicking means copying from nature. The researchers were inspired by blue tarantula spider, which is non-iridescent. Non-iridescent means the structural color does not change even if you change the viewing angle or at the angle with which you are seeing. So they carried out transmission electron microscopy to find out internal microscopic structure of the spider leg or the structures which gives this blue color. Then they made the structures using nanoscribe that uses two photon polymerization with writing resolution of 200 nanometer. And finally, through trial and error and theoretical simulation, they perfected the design which actually mimics the blue spider. So question comes, how can you fabricate photonic crystal? This is nanoscribe making micron size spaceship from Star Trek. You thought physics and engineering is boring, but we have our own way of having fun. Ha 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 ha. Nanoscribe works on two photon polymerization where piezo driven actuators or motors, focus optics and laser can create structures of resolution 200 nanometer. Two photon polymerization uses femtosecond laser. Because of tight focus and extremely high energy, nonlinear optical phenomenon happens where absorbed infrared light can polymerize materials that is sensitive to ultraviolet. Another process is called electron beam lithography. It is similar to electron microscopy. Here also electric and magnetic lenses is used to focus the beam. As we all know, the wavelength of electron is less than the visible light and energy is also more. Hence, structural resolution of 1 nanometer to 20 nanometer can be achieved. When electron strikes the polymer undergoes chemical changes. Polymer where electrons hit, if it's washed away after developing, it is called positive resist. Polymer, if it stays after the electron has striked its surface, then it is called negative resist. Negative resist usually stays and rest all the polymer material gets washed away. Electron beam can be specifically tuned for specific structures. Electron beam can be Gaussian or shaped beam. It can make structures using vector scanning or raster scanning. Here, the substrate is pin-coated using PMMA or polymethyl methacrylate. Then EBL is done over it. Developing is done. Where EBL is done, PMMA is etched out. Aluminium is deposited, PMMA is lifted, aluminium is etched away, and the structure is formed. Compounds of aluminium and zinc are vapor deposited in thin films of plastic. Multiple plastic films are stacked together and then they take on a blue appearance. These blue sheets are shredded into microparticles and the paint is developed. Photolithography uses an opaque mask having a geometrical pattern, which is placed just above the photosensitive material. After the exposure, the substrate with the exposed photoresist is developed or chemically treated, and patterns like that of the mask or the inverse of the mask can be seen on the substrate. Mainly UV light is used for doing photolithography. Focused ion beam lithography or FIB lithography is more or less similar to electron beam lithography. But here, instead of electrons, ions like that of gallium, gold, iridium are used. Ions hit the substrate and takes out or sputters out some materials, hence giving the shape of the design structure on the substrate that is desired. Holographic lithography is also called interference lithography. It is mask-free, low-cost, and compatible to large-scale photonic crystal manufacturing. Fringe-to-fringe spacing or period is given by lambda by 2 whole divided by sine theta by 2. Lambda is the wavelength, theta is the angle between two interfering waves. Laser beam needs to be coherent. By using 3-beam interference, arrays with hexagonal symmetry can be generated. By using 4-beam arrays with rectangular symmetry or 3D photonic crystal can be generated. Chemical etching is another way of forming photonic crystal. This can be wet etching or dry etching, so acid or plasma is used for etching. It can be isotropic, anisotropic. Lot of optimization needs to be done for desired result. So here is an example of photonic crystal over silicon, where silicon wafer is coated with photoresist exposed to UV light through a mask. The wafer is chemically etched and the structure is formed. Similarly, another technique used is self-assembly of silica or polymer beads, which is 300 nanometer to 1000 nanometer size. The size of the beads are chosen according to the wavelength it is designed for. The real challenge is in preparation or the synthesis of these beads. Self-ordering or assembly of the beads happen by centrifugation, sedimentation or deposition of capillary forces on planar surface. Imprint lithography is fast, cheap, widely used, so a hard pattern substrate or template is placed against the polymer and heat or light is applied. If the polymer is moldable, then it is poured over the template and peeled off after curing. This is micro lens made with imprint lithography. Sometimes two or more techniques are also combined to create photonic crystal, such as inject printing and self-assembly of microspheres like shown in the figure above. A CD is taken, foil part is peeled off with a sellotape, and any water-soluble transparent glue like in India Fevigum is poured onto that part, CD part. So it is left to dry for 2 days. And then after, the glue film is peeled off. So diffraction pattern is checked using a high and a low power laser, because in high power laser the camera exposure of mine gets messed up. So you remember some Samsung or Oppo Vivo phones, if you change the viewing angle of the back glass, it changes the color. So that is actually because of the photonic crystal. So those actually, when you change the viewing angle, those are actually made up of photonic crystal layers or photonic crystal film. So lastly, the chameleon skin change has crystal sac. So those crystal, if come closer or goes further, the color of the skin actually changes. So chameleon also changes the color of its skin using a photonic crystal.
So that is for now. We will meet.
Hey, wait. Who are you?
So, I am from your future.
Okay.
So, you will not ask them to like, share and subscribe?
Please, like, share, subscribe.
Kids that days.